Hello everyone, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 276. Vivo V23 and V23 Pro smartphones have been launched in India. V23 Pro features a unique color-changing Fortnite AG pack panel that shifts color when exposed to bright light. Now let's talk about the specifications of these two smartphones. Vivo V23 5G comes with a 6.44-inch Full HD Plus 90Hz AMOLED display, which comes with a Dimensity 1200 processor. It is having a 64-megapixel triple rear camera. It has a 4200mAh battery which supports a 44-watt fast charging. And if we talk about the specifications of Vivo V23 Pro 5G, it comes with a 6.56-inch Full HD Plus 90Hz AMOLED display. It runs on the same Dimensity 1200 processor, but the camera is around 108-megapixel triple rear cameras. And it comes with a 4300mAh battery which supports 44-watt fast charging. IQ 9 series has been unveiled officially. The IQ 9 and 9 Pro flagship shipped with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset, 120W fast charging and a 50-megapixel primary camera. IQ 9 series price starts at 3,999 Chinese Yuan, that is approximately ₹46,900. Dezo Watch R and Buds Z Pro wearables have been launched in India. Realme Dezo Watch R is priced at ₹3,999, while the Buds Z costs ₹2,999. The Watch R has a 1.3-inch AMOLED display. The Buds Z Pro has an active noise cancellation up to 25 decibels. Fossil has announced two new smartwatches today, the Razer X Fossil Gen 6 and a Skagen Falster Gen 6. Both run on the Snapdragon Wear 4100 Plus platform and the compatible with the Wear OS 3. The special edition Razer X Fossil Gen 6 smartwatch is done with the collaboration with the gaming brand and is a custom variant of the Fossil Gen 6, which has been around since August. This watch comes with a 3 Razer themed faces and an elemental of Razer throughout the interface. The Razer Chroma face has different lighting effects and it is customizable. The Razer X Fossil Gen 6 is coming later this month for $329 in very exclusive 1337 units, a number paying homepage to lead. The Skagen Falster Gen 6 is coming later this month, which is priced around $295. Intel has launched 8 new 12th generation Intel Core 8 series processor along with the flagship Intel Core i9-12900HK chipset. The chipmaker also introduced the Intel Arc discrete graphic platform, which will be shipped to OEMs. Intel's Mobileye branch announced the new IQ Ultra processor for the autonomous vehicles. And then from Asus, Asus was all about gaming at CES 2022 with all new models in its ROG Zephyrus and Flow series. Asus ROG Zephyrus Duo 16 is a dual screen gaming laptop with a 16-inch primary screen and a 14.1-inch touchscreen. This laptop supports up to AMD Ryzen 9 6900HZ processor and an NVIDIA RTX 3080 Ti graphics card. The Asus ROG Zephyrus Z14 and G15 and the ROG Flow X13 are AMD powered laptops that can be powered with up to 32GB of RAM and a 1TB of storage. And then from Dell, Dell showed off its premium XPS 13 Plus laptop with an all-new design and a haptic touchpad. It features larger keys with no space between them. And the laptop is powered by a 12th generation Intel Core P-series processors. Dell had more announcement in the gaming segment with the new Alienware X14, X15 and X17 laptops supporting up to Intel Core i7 processor and an NVIDIA RTX 3080 Ti GPU. It also announced the Alienware M17 R5 Ryzen Edition with up to AMD Ryzen 9 6980HX processor and an NVIDIA 3060 GPU. Acer at CES 2022 took off the wraps of new Chromebooks and the gaming laptops. It announced the Chromebook Spin 513, Chromebook 315 and a Chromebook 314. The Acer Chromebook Spin 513 is powered by a MediaTek Companion 1380 processor, while the Chromebook 315 and Chromebook 314 feature the Intel Celeron processor. Acer also announced the Predator Triton 500SC, Predator Helio 300 gaming laptops with the latest 12th generation Intel Core processor and an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 30 series laptop GPU. The Acer Nitro 5 also comes with an AMD Ryzen 6000 models. Two Nokia C series and two Nokia G series phones have been launched. The price of this phone starts at $99 or about ₹7,400. A new Nokia flip phone has also been debuted along with these four smartphones. OPPO Enco M32, the wireless neckband, claims to give users up to 20 hours of playback on a 10-minute charge. It arrives with a significant upgrades compared to the OPPO Enco M31. The device is IP55 certified dust and water resistance. Xiaomi is unveiling a wide array of products during the first event for 2022. The lineup of devices launched during the mega event including laptops, smartphone gadgets, TVs and 6 new Android-based tablets. The Android tablets included the TCL Next Paper 10S, Tab 10L and Tab 8 4G, Tiki Max and Tiki Mid and Tiki Mini. These 6 Android tablets feature a number of exciting functions, with the Tiki series representing the new KDE tablets. The 6 tablets will be available in China and Europe in this strategic manner from January 2022. Except for the Tiki Mini, all other tablets will run on the Android 11 operating system. Sony has announced the specifications of PlayStation VR 2 and PlayStation VR 2 Sense controller. It has also offered a sneak peek of Horizon Call of the Mountain VR game designed for PlayStation VR 2. The launch date announcement of PlayStation VR 2 and Horizon Call of the Mountain VR game are expected to come soon. Realme Book Enhanced Edition features the Intel Core i5 11th generation Willow Core processor. It gets an improved dual fan cooling system with a 32.7% heat dissipation. The Enhanced Edition is priced at around 4,700 Chinese yuan, that is approximately ₹55,000, and is currently available only in China. The Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition pre-orders can be placed on the official Indian website till January 10. Customers can pre-order this smartphone by paying a sum of ₹999. The Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition price is rumored to be around ₹52,000. OnePlus 10 Pro specifications have been revealed by the company. OnePlus 10 Pro launch is set for January 11th. The key specifications include a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset, 48-megapixel triple cameras, Android 12 OS and a 5000mAh battery. The Redmi K50 series is expected to launch in February in China. The Redmi K50 series will feature a dual vapor chamber cooling Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor and a 120W charging. The Redmi K50 series might launch in India as a Xiaomi 12X lineup. The Redmi Note 11S is a Redmi's next Note 11 series smartphone. This device is said to feature a 90Hz refresh rate display and a 108MP camera. We now have an exclusive intel surrounding its global launch. The Moto G Stylus 2022 refresh, which is expected to be a Motorola's budget stylus smartphone offering, has had multiple leaks in the past, with a recent one revealing the looks and design of the upcoming device in 5K renders. Now another leak has surfaced on Twitter with presumably the official renders for the device as well as some key specifications. A triple camera setup with an LED flash can be observed on the back. Additionally, the image also features a side-mounted fingerprint sensor and a centered camera punch hole. The stylus pen looks more premium compared to the 2021 Moto G stylus. This smartphone was intended to come with a 6.81 inch display and have a Snapdragon 480 Plus 5G chipset. In December 2021, Elon Musk's Starlink internet services stopped accepting pre-orders in India. Now the company has started to refund the pre-order amount to users. This is due to the company's not having the required license to operate in India. Realme 9i designer specifications have been leaked in a new leak. The key specifications include a Snapdragon 680 processor, 50MP triple cameras and a 5000mAh battery. Realme 9i design includes a punch hole cutout, triple cameras and a side-mounted fingerprint sensor. Call of Duty Mobile Public Test Build is now available on iOS and Android devices. Call of Duty Mobile Public Test Build allows players to try out new content before everyone else. The developer will gather feedback from players who tried out the Call of Duty Mobile Public Test Build. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.